Today we'll show how we draped this polo shirt in two different colorways using TUKA3D. TUKA3D is a 3D software for virtual sample making, so we can see how this style will look and fit on a 3D fit model before anything is cut and sewn. The pattern for this shirt was created in the TUKAcad software for pattern making, grading, and marker making. This means that after the virtual sample is approved, we will already have a pattern that is ready to go to production. For 3D sample making, we always use the 0-0 pattern, meaning there is no seam allowance and no scaling or shrinkage. This way, we can see how the garment will look at its final specs. We arranged the pattern pieces so they would be easier to work with later in TUKA3D, then opened the TUKA3D software and added in the TUKAcad pattern. Next, we selected a cotton jersey fabric for the self and a rib fabric from TUKA3D's library, which has hundreds of fabrics to choose from. We also brought in the 3D fit model, which was custom built for this brand based on their real-life fit model. TUKA3D fit models are sculpted from 3D body scan data, so there is zero tolerance between what we see on the screen and what we will see in real life. After we selected our CAD pattern, 3D model, and fabrication, we arranged the panel pieces around the body. We placed the front and back panels around the torso, the sleeves around the arms, and the collar around the neck, around where they would be after being stitched together. Next, we stitched the pieces together similar to how they would be sewn in real life. For example, we stitched the front and back together at the side seams and shoulders, then the sleeves into the armhole and the collar to the neck. To make this process faster, we turned on mirror stitching so that the stitching applied to one side of the garment would also be applied to the other side of the garment. After all the stitching was done, we started the draping process. First, we hid the sleeves and collar, then draped the front and back panels without gravity. This just brings the seams together without letting the garment fall or simulate fabric properties. After the pieces were stitched, we draped with gravity and could see the fall of the fabric. We locked these pieces so they stay where they are, then showed the collar and sleeves and repeated the draping process. Now in this case, the collar didn't come out very well, so we just reset that piece and re-simulated it, and it looked much better. We were happy with how this pattern came out on the 3D fit model. One of the advantages of TUKA3D is that the software comes with built-in motion simulation, so we can see how this garment looks and fits when the model moves. This is really useful for doing fitting tests or for final presentations. This model had a walking motion, which worked well for this polo shirt style, so we created the simulation. We were able to check how comfortable the garment was by turning on tension mapping. This shows how tight and loose the garment is with a color scale and even reacts to the motion simulation. Since this garment is a knit, a little bit of red on the shoulder is not uncomfortable, so we were satisfied with both the look and the fit of this polo shirt. Next, we created two different colorways for this style. Before adding artwork, we needed to make sure that the texture of the fabric would show in the final renderings, so we added bump maps for the rib and jersey fabrics. These bump maps are also included with the TUKA3D library. We also added buttons as 3D trims, changed their size and color, and placed them on top of the buttonholes. Next, we created the planar map files for this style. These are flat templates of the CAD pattern layout, which we used to add the artwork to this style. We chose to edit the planar map files in Photoshop, but they are compatible with any graphic design software. For the first colorway, we did a fun, Christmassy plaid design for the self pieces and a solid red contrast on the ribbing. We rendered images of this colorway with the model hidden directly in TUKA3D. TUKA3D has a V-Ray rendering option, which creates nice, high-quality renders of 3D samples. For the second colorway, we created something a little more year-round with maroon all over. This time, we also added an embroidery detail.